You are with The Big Story here with us. I'm Sahar Zaman. Today, we are marking, celebrating the Shera. But for the victims of the Amritsar train tragedy, it's exactly 1 year on and they're still waiting for justice. The case, the horrifying, unbelievable tragedy in which 60 people were mowed down by a train during a Dashera celebration this year, the Amritsar administration, has it really learned a lesson? There are several measures, though, that they have taken to prevent any similar tragedy. Permission that has been granted to organizers only after the venues have been checked. While Ravan effigies were burnt in 19 places last year, this time it has come down to 10 places with far more scrutiny. 10 places granted permission. Meanwhile, families of the victims, though, of the case of last year, they've been protesting, demanding justice. They say that they're going to protest on that very railway track. In light of this, in the given area, there is heavy police deployment there at Jorhat-Patak railway track. You should remember, this is exactly a year on. The case has made no forward movement. There have been no arrests. There is no charge sheet that has been filed. And the SIT has still not reached a conclusion. The probe team there is still awaiting, putting a full stop on that, awaiting here for the forensic report in the case. The victims here claim that the former Punjab minister, the Amritsar East MLA, Navjot Singh Sidhu, has not kept his promise of government jobs to one member of each family or providing compensation. This is what we're asking. All that families of tragedy ask for is justice. Has there been any forward movement at all with those investigations? I'm going to throw this open to our panelists this afternoon in just a bit. First, getting in those crucial inputs from our correspondent, Alok, with what are we looking at hand with 1 year on. Alok, any further evidence that is scrutinized, any conclusion that is made whatsoever, where to pin the blame here?
Well, Afrida, if we talk particularly about this incident that had happened on 19th of October last year, and there were hundreds of people standing on the track, and when they were moved down by a train, they were witnessing the Dashera event. There was a Ravan effigy was being burnt. After that incident, in fact, three separate inquiries were ordered, and that one was by the railway. That railway, Indian Railways, did the inquiry in which they gave the clean chit to their driver as well as the gatekeeper of that Jorhat-Patak. The second inquiry was done by the magistrate. Mm-hmm. In the magisterial inquiry, however, there were some loopholes found out. And in fact, in that inquiry, magistrate had held accountable the organizer as well as the administration of that particular time. The third inquiry, in fact, that was being conducted by the government railway police. So here is the main inquiry that is being conducted by the government railway police, where the case was also registered. The government railway police registered the case under section of 304, 304A, 337, 338 of the IPC. In fact, they collected the sample from the spot and they sent it to the CFSL for the forensic laboratory for the test. And now the government railway police says that they are still awaiting that report from the laboratory to go further into this case. But the question we are asking, Seher, is that it's already 11 months have passed, but...
Yes, Alok, exactly. What are these FSL details here that are taking so interminably long?
Yes, exactly, Seher, that what the police officials, in fact, the SIT members told to the Mirror now that these samples are the blood samples that were collected from the stains, that the blood stains from the train as well as the blood stains from the ground as well as the railway track. They want to match it as and say that these were the human blood. But irony is that report hasn't come, or they haven't found that report as the SIT member says that they they haven't got the report. So that is why they are delaying it. They are saying that they have already recorded the statements of the people who were basically allegedly involved, whether they were the organizer or the administrative officials. In fact, there were hundreds of people whose statements have been recorded, which include the organizer, that is the Mitthu Madan, who is in fact the Congress supporter as well as the Congress worker who had organized that event just beside the railway track in Joda Fatak, and where the chief guest was Navjot Kaur Sidhu at that point in time. So as of now, the SIT, which was formed under the GRP government railway police, they are investigating the case, but as of now they haven't reached any conclusion. They are still awaiting the laboratory report, and they have also not yet filed the charge sheet into this case. So the people are still awaiting justice. And
all right, we have fairly established where the delays are taking place, and we could scrutinize why the delay. Yes, no arrest, no FIR, no charge sheet. Alok, thanks for highlighting that. But stay on with us. Let's throw this open to our panelists. We have Mr. Badshah Sain, senior journalist with us, Abdul Razak, political analyst. First to you, Mr. Sain. In having taken into account of what has happened in the past year, three inquiries, three separate bodies inquiring this, there is a hold because of an FSL report that is awaited. Do you think that this is a delay that can be taken into account? This is a delay that we could believe in, or this is an intentional delay to this?
Well, I mean, I'd sort of divide the subject into two. One is the delay in providing succor, relief, support to people whose near and dear ones have died in that accident. You do not need blood samples and whose blood they are, whether they're human blood or animal blood, to provide relief instantly. I mean, we've had cases here of floods, which are a natural phenomenon. Nobody can be blamed, perhaps, for the floods. But relief is provided within months, if not days, of the event taking place. So I do not understand how that forensic report, or any report for that matter, is standing in the way of providing relief, which, of course, ranges from offers of jobs for one member of the family per person killed. Otherwise, cash relief, I believe. I remember a year ago, Mr. Sidhu, then minister in Punjab government, had promised something like 10,000, 11,000 rupees, I think, a month. I may be wrong. To each of the families who lost one or two members amongst them. So that relief has not come. Now we got to the next stage, which is the second part, and which is the investigation into this accident. Three, as your colleague said from Amritsar, three inquiries have taken place. A 300-page report has been filed, and we don't know what the findings of those report are. Indeed, Mitthu Madan, the son of a councillor, Congress councillor, and a Congress worker, Mitthu Madan, who organized this function, he mysteriously fled and was missing for days. Yes. To some extent points a finger at possible culpability. He's back and he's roaming around. He doesn't need relief. He needs to be in jail. He organized an illegal or an irregular function. And he's the first person who should be behind bars, is my belief. Certainly, he should be put before a court of law and tried for all those mistakes. Now, then comes the case of the Sidhus.
Okay, let's take some of what you've just stated here to Mr. Abdul Razak, political analyst with here as well. Yes, Mr. Abdul Razak, given that these were compensation promises and promises of justice that were made by the sitting minister of that time, Navjot Singh Sidhu, who of course is no longer part of the cabinet, but irrespective of that, this remains the responsibility of the state Punjab government, of Captain Amrinder Singh's government here, to ensure that these people get justice. There have been multiple delays in three separate inquiries. It seems that three separate inquiries have only further worked towards complicating this case instead of resolving the issue.
Sahar, first of all, it was a very unfortunate incident on this holy occasion. You know, I feel for the families of those victims
of course
who lost their near and dear ones and who are injured. Now, The state government of Punjab immediately released 5 lakh rupees that was compensation that was promised. The central government also released 2 lakhs to the victims' families. The demands from these families is that they need a government job. Now, since that Indian Railways is a central government-owned entity, the onus lies on the central government to provide them jobs. I do remember the then Railway Minister Piyush Goyalji flew back from United States. He very categorically mentioned on the same day that he made those promises that, you know, the jobs would be given. It was not Navjot Singh Sidhu to be held responsible. It is the Railway Minister. This is the government which did not shy away from using this disaster in their election campaign ahead of the 5-state elections last year, if you remember. Now, when it comes to providing jobs, this is the government which promised 2 crore jobs every year, failing which today the people in every corner of the country is questioning the government. I was going through the Railway Ministry website just now.
Yes.
There are so many vacancies. It is a finger-click job if the Railway Minister really wants to give them jobs. But this is not a government which could deliver. They can only talk close to elections and they enjoy power for the next 5 years. Now, coming back to the incident was definitely planned and executed by a Congress worker maybe, but the event was very far away from the railway tracks. People stood there on the tracks to have a better view of the event because the Ravana would be burnt there. Now, the responsibility of clearing the tracks before any train could come there lies on the RPF. The Railway Protection Force has
is
to
once again and the
that
Central
the tracks
Railways.
Are clear.
Right.
It was informed.
Absolutely.
Yes. So what I'm saying
Abdul
is,
Razak, we take that into account of what you just pointed out here. Let's also go across
here
to my colleague Sanjana, getting
so
us further details. Sanjana, because at the end of the day, irrespective of which authority is responsible to catch the culprits here, with 3 separate inquiries, this is a convoluted scenario. In perhaps the state wanting to protect the central wanting to protect the state, and each wanting to protect their own, except for helping the victims' families.
Absolutely, Sahar, because let me actually take you through what the magisterial probe even said. It was a 300 probe report that was filed back in December of 2018. It did, of course, give a clean chit to the Sidhus. Let's remember, Navjot Singh Sidhu, a little after that, has been MIA, missing in action. This is especially after he promised the victims that he would provide compensation to them, that he would provide government jobs to them. But we've been seeing victims protesting every day outside the Sidhu's residence because they have received nothing. So if I can just ask my producers to just show the magisterial probe. It did, of course, highlight the lapse by the organizer, one of them, of course, the Congress councillor's son, Mithu Singh Madan, who held event without permission, without any safety measures that were in place. That was one of the glaring lapses that were exposed. After that, there was a lapse, of course, by the police. Because let's remember, the actual number of police present at the event is still not known, but most of them who were deployed were not near the railway tracks. There was nobody there to warn the victims that, look, there was a train going to come here. It's going to be speeding, moving fast, so move behind. They were all deployed for VVIP duties ahead, which is extremely disheartening to hear. After that, the probe report also highlighted the lapses by the railway, who failed to take safety measures. There was no warning. There was poor lighting. Let's also remember that it was completely dark. There were these horrific visuals that we all saw on our screens that day, that it was completely dark when this train came and mowed down over 60 people. There were no lights. There was no red flags. There was no crossing. There was none of that. And lastly, of course, expose the lapse by the municipal corporation that provide water tankers without requisite permission. So, of course, you know, there was a space constraint. So what the Punjab government is trying to do this year, of course, attempting to learn from their lessons. But Sahar, the situation is still that there's been no justice that's been delivered to the victims. There's been no action. There's been no charge sheet. There's been no arrest that has taken place so far. Lastly, the fire department too, because they sent a fire tender without verifying municipality's permission. This is one of the biggest glaring lapses ahead, because let's remember that last year, in 2018, there were at least 19 locations in Amritsar where these effigies were burnt. But this year, only 10 of these locations have been given this tender. So it goes to show that at least there are 9 to 10 places, and Amritsar is not a very, very big city. At least 9 to 10 locations which are still unsafe.
Yes. Okay. One could look into if one really wants to be hopeful about the positives in this tragedy, some corrective measure of reducing the number of areas where the Shehra would be observed under strict measures here. But let's also get in our correspondent. I beg your pardon, Mr. Badshah Sain, you were of the view here that as far as nabbing the culprits in the state police, the state SIT, they're doing its job. But is it not a curious case if you have an inquiry by the Central Railways in giving a clean chit to the driver and the gatekeeper, and they're responsible to ensuring that the ground is clear, the tracks are clear before the train passes through? How is that not being questioned? I mean, you can question about not giving jobs as compensation, but if the Central Railways gives its own a clean chit, where is the question of the jobs compensation from them? It seems that the Central Railways is not at fault.
Well, I seem to recall that the railway's report was over very fast. I'm amazed. There is one investigation which is going on for more than a year, and the railway's investigated, and within 2-3 days or 5 days, I'm not sure how many days, they came to the conclusion that they were not at fault. So there's a mismatch between the various inquiries in terms of time taken. Second point is, I'm a bit hazy about this. Last year, I remember that there were two trains going, and the train coming from the opposite direction, the driver, I believe, did sound some sort of warning to the other train that, look, there's a crowd building up on the track. I do not recall whether that actually, that's what I remember happening. So the driver, in the meantime, had sped up because he was looking at the green signal and so on. The gatekeeper is one person you could hold responsible to some extent about allowing these crowds. Mm-hmm. Mostly, I would suggest that until recently, if not even now, Amritsar is a very sensitive border region of India. I presume that in such cases where you have terrorists running around all over the place, dropping bombs and so on, that the railway track going past Amritsar should be very well patrolled by the Railway Protection Force. What if today, find that we don't have Dasara going
let's
on,
take that
but somebody plants a bomb
Mr. RP
on that
Singh,
track?
Spokesperson
Who's
of the
watching
BGP
that?
Here with us? Mr. RP Singh, thank you for being with us here. If we scrutinize three inquiries that have taken place in the past year, a tragedy of this proportion, a massive tragedy in which 60 people mowed down, run over by a speeding train, 60 people reported dead on a tragedy that has taken place on the railway tracks. How does the inquiry set up by the Central Railways Committee give a clean chit, to the driver and the gatekeeper? Why should that not be questioned today? It may sound late in the day, but this has been one full year and we're still waiting for justice for the victims. Mr. R.P. Singh.
Well, I would have appreciated if you had called someone from the Railway Department to tell you what detailed inquiry they have done and how they reached to the conclusion. But I also remember there was an inquiry which was assigned to by the local government, by the Captain Amritsar Singh government, to local one of the DMs there. And it has not found anyone guilty for holding their function and putting screens, huge screens, next to the railway line. So I'm not forwarding the blame game to some, like to one or the other. But as I remember last year, I was on your channel only,
You don't want this to be a blame game. We're asking you because the Central Railway is under the central government, which is why we're asking you this.
No, that's what I said. I mean, I don't know. I'm not aware of the inquiry because that happened that time. And it gave a clean chit to the driver person who was there at the level crossing. Because level crossing was not open for public, but it was only because there were people on the track. And people on the track because there were huge screens being put. And announcements were being made from the stage saying that so many thousand people have come to see you. They're admirers. It was said to Mrs. Sidhu, Navjot Kaur Sidhu. But nothing happened. Nothing went forward on that. And not even that person who was organizer of that complete function has been held guilty. There's no case, no nothing against that person, as per my information. He's still going free. Probably, I've been told that he has been awarded some sort of political assignment, some sort of government assignment by the Punjab government.
Mr. Singh, you're still looking at this politically here. If we look at this plainly as a tragedy taken on the railway tracks, this is something that should rest on the Central Railways, irrespective of what the event was. Of course, that needs to be taken into account as well. But because this is a tragedy taking place on the railway tracks, the Central Railways should have been more forthcoming in this with respect to their inquiry instead of giving an absolute clean chit. How do you give an absolute clean chit to the driver and the gatekeeper when there's so many people on ground? How could those people not be seen? That is the question here. But I'm going to still take your argument into account and pose your question to the Congress here. Dr. Rajkumar Varga, spokesperson of the Congress, with us over the phone line. Dr. Rajkumar, thank you for being with us here. This is being questioned equally as far as the Congress government here in Punjab is concerned. The organizer of this entire Dashera celebration, when was enticing people, enticing larger crowds to come across and watch the celebrations here? Why is he roaming free today?
देखिए वहाँ पे जो दशहरा है पिछले 30 साल से हो रहा है, 30 साल से हो रहा है, और कोई नई बात नहीं थी उसमें, और कोई ये कांग्रेस पार्टी की ओर से दशहरा नहीं होता है, लोगों की ओर से जो लोकल कमेटी है वहाँ दशहरा करती है, एज ए चीफ गेस्ट वो किसी को भी बुलाते हैं, बहुत से समय लंबा समय तक अकाली दल के मंत्री जाते रहे हैं, और उसके बाद जब कांग्रेस का राज आता है कांग्रेस के लोगों को बुलाते हैं। सवाल ये नहीं, सवाल
मतलब डॉक्टर राजकुमार, अगर ये पिछले 3-4 साल से हो रहा है तो पिछले 3-4 साल में भी भीड़ जमा ऐसे होती थी रेलवे ट्रैक्स पे? ये खास लास्ट पिछले साल ही कैसे भीड़ इतनी जमा हुई रेलवे ट्रैक्स पे? हु अलाउड दिस?
मैं वही कह रहा हूँ कि देखना एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन का काम रहता है। पहली बात तो ये है कि ये 30 साल से लगातार वहां पे दशहरा हो रहा था, अचानक ये जो हादसा दुखांत हुआ है इसमें रेलवे का, जहां ये दशहरा होता है, ये रेलवे क्रॉसिंग है, वहां पे एक रेलवे का वहां स्टाफ करीब 5 लोग ड्यूटी पे रहते हैं, ऊपर टावर है जहां पे ये देखते हैं सारी चीज को, नीचे ये दशहरा हो रहा है, क्या उन्होंने कोई अपने हेडक्वार्टर को इसकी सूचना नहीं दी? पहला सवाल। दूसरी ये है कि जो ट्रेन इतनी फास्ट आई है उसने कुछ नहीं देखा। हम अब ये है
क्या आपके ऑर्गेनाइजर ने सूचना दी रेलवे को?
उनको दी, डिप्टी कमिश्नर को दी, और वहां वहां उन लोगों से परमिशन ली गई और वो दशहरा हुआ। और उसके बाद मैंने ये कहा कि ये रेलवे का फॉल्ट ज्यादा है इसमें, कि रेलवे की अपनी भी एक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी रहती है कि यहाँ अगर ऐसा फंक्शन हो रहा है कि ऊपर टावर है,
डॉक्टर वर्का, सारे पॉलिटिशियंस को दूसरे में ही फॉल्ट नजर आएगा, अपने में कोई फॉल्ट नहीं नजर आता। दिस इज अ केस इन विच यू हैव all parties involved equally at fault. The railways at fault, the state government at fault. Why those permissions were sought, why were they granted, why was the Central Railways not holding their own people, the driver and the gatekeeper, responsible here? You have all authorities involved here in this being at fault, which is why perhaps we're looking at a deadlock even in the investigations. Are they each trying to protect their own? Remember, this is a case where you have no FIR, 1 year on, no arrest, no charge sheet. They're obviously protecting each other here instead of thinking about the victims, while the victims still waiting for justice, still waiting for closure. Even if they ask about compensation and jobs, the Central Railways makes it very clear it's not their fault. So therefore, no jobs. Compensation in money that has been provided here. But this is a tragedy that each family has to deal with for their entire life. Not just a question of being 1 year today. This is a tragedy that they've been living through, struggling through an entire life on the sudden loss that they suffered last year. Thanks for being with us.